Okay, so I've told you what Lute is and how it works in simple terms. You can watch that in this video up here or in the description. In this video, I'm going to show you how to actually install Lute because I know it can be kind of a complicated process if you're not used to messing with the Windows command prompt and PowerShell and all those things. I'm going to show you like a step-by-step installation of Lute, and you should be able to get it up and running. If you're someone who prefers to read instead of watch, I've also prepared a written tutorial. I've tried to make it as simple as possible. This is a tutorial for Windows, by the way. I am not going to show you how to install it in different operating systems because I simply do not know how to do it, but you will again find tutorials in the description and you can ask questions on the Discord server or in the comments and we can all help each other get Lute up and running. So here we go. You will find all of the links in the description and you can also find them in the written guide. The first thing you need to do is to install Python. You just need to go to the Python downloads page and click here. Once this is downloaded, you can just execute it. It's a really easy installation. The only thing you need to make sure you check is this right here. It's very important that you check this option, which says add python. exe to path, and also check the first one to use admin privileges. But that's all you need to do. I'm not going to show you because I've already installed Python, but I don't think you'll have trouble with this step. Once you've installed Python, what we need to do is to create an environment for Lute to work. We're simply going to create a new folder. You can do this on your desktop or wherever you prefer. I'm going to call this folder Lute3, but you can call it whatever you want. If you want to make this easier, just name the folders in the way that I do. So we create a new folder called Lute3, and what we're going to do now is to open PowerShell. So you need to open Windows search function and write PowerShell. Once you find this, you right-click it, and then you click Run as Administrator. You are going to be asked for confirmation from Windows, and then this PowerShell terminal is going to open. Let's go back to this folder that we created. What you need to do is click right here on the bar, right-click it, and then choose Copy Address. Back on our PowerShell window, we just need to write CD and then paste the address of the folder that we've created, then press enter, and you'll get this new line. You need to make sure that everything appears as it does on my screen, so it says PS and then the directory of our folder. Now we need to paste this command that you will see on the screen, and the part where it says env-lute, that's the name of your Lute environment. If you don't want to mess with this, just copy everything exactly as I'm doing it and then press enter. You're going to have to wait just a few seconds and then the Lute environment is ready now. If we go back to the folder that we created, we will see that something else has appeared in there and this is our Lute environment. In the next step, we install Lute directly. So we open up PowerShell again. And what we need to do now is to activate this environment that we've created. Paste what you see on screen, and you're gonna hit enter. Remember that if you, for some reason, close PowerShell, you always need to redirect it to your directory by copying the address and making sure that it says ps and the directory of the folder we've created before you do anything else. But for now, we've activated the environment. If you've done everything right so far, you're going to see the name of your environment between parentheses and in green here, and then your directory. And now we just need to install it. This is as simple as pasting this command that you see on screen and hitting enter. This is going to take a while longer, but it shouldn't take that much. This is real time and it's done. If you see that message saying that a new release of pip is available, you can update it following the instructions, or you can just ignore it. It's fine. We've successfully installed Lute. All you need to do now is to launch Lute and start using it. To do this, you simply have to paste this command that you see on screen, hit enter, and Lute is running. Now, with that PowerShell window open, all you need to do is to open your favorite browser like Chrome or Edge and just write this that you see up here, localhost colon 5000. You just press enter and Lute is open and ready for you to use. You are going to see some example texts in here. As I said in my previous video, it is advisable that you go through the tutorial and the tutorial follow up. But yeah, it's as simple as that. Now Lute is running. When you want to stop using Lute, you simply have to close your browser and then close the PowerShell window and everything will be saved automatically. You do not need to worry about that. The thing is, you have to repeat this process every time you want to launch Lute. So suppose you just booted up your computer and you want to use Lute again, you would go to the folder you created, Lute3, copy this address, look for PowerShell and open it up with administrator privileges, and you simply would, as we did before, write cd and then the directory. Once this is done, you activate the environment with the same command that we used before, and we simply write the command to actually launch Lute, and that's it. You can again go to your browser, open it up, and it will be working. You can create a shortcut to do all of this automatically, so you don't have to paste all of those commands each time you want to use Lute. So let's try that out. You need to create a new text file, a normal txt file, and name it whatever you want. For example, launch Lute. Within this txt file, you need to paste three lines of code, and they are lines that we've used before. So the first one takes us to our folder that we created. The next one activates the Lute environment, and the other one opens up or launches Lute itself. You just save it. And now this file, this text file that you created, change its extension to ps1 and save it. If you cannot see the txt extension, you can just go and do a quick Windows search and look for show file extensions. Open that up. And then down here where it says File Explorer, next to change settings to show file extensions, click on show settings. And on this window, you need to look for hide extensions for known file types and make sure that is unchecked. Once you click OK, you will be able to see the extension of your files and change the txt for PS1. But let's go back to our file. To launch Lute, you simply need to double click this file and PowerShell will open and launch Lute automatically. If for some reason when you open it up you get a text file, you can just right click it and then choose run with PowerShell. And that's it, Lute will be launched. You can check that it's working by going to the address. That's an easier and quicker way to launch Lute every time you want to use it. Lute is always updating, so you can go to the change log, which I'm also going to leave in the description, and you will see that new versions are coming out all of the time. You can check which version of Lute you have by going to this tab right here inside of the program. You just go to about and then version and software info. You can see that I'm running version 3.0.6, which is the latest one. If you want to update Lute, you have to navigate to the directory of our Lute folder, cd, and the directory. Now we need to again activate the environment with our command. And finally, we just need to paste this command. It's very similar to the one we used to install it, but in this case, it just checks to see if there's any update and automatically updates Lute. Now you can normally launch Lute with our launching command and you will be good to go. I hope this was useful to you. I'm here for any questions you may have. I hope you have a great day and I'll see you in the next video.